rep past District 59. I am hopeful that none of you took the time to read my bill. Because it's not ready. What do I mean by that? And so as I was working with Ledge Council on drafting the bill, which is kind of a product of and a companion bill to the work group that we have, task force, the AG's task force on public records. And, you know, we were able to, in a brief window of time of less than a year, agree on some things that we put in a Senate bill that has already had a hearing. There were other things that we started talking about, components of what needed to be done with public records, that we started talking about toward the end of the task force as we were running out of time. So I decided to go ahead and start working with Ledge Council to try to figure out how to approach some of the stuff that I was hearing in the room that people might be able to support. And so as we were working on the process, Suzanne said, so this is a paid job. How much time do you want me to spend on it? And I said, well, why don't you just get it to a point where we can get it to session and start having the conversation, which we have been having. I've had numerous meetings the last few weeks around House Bill 2101. And I think there's a lot of support for trying to do something. And so out of those conversations, I thought what I would do is kind of present to the committee what I envision based on those conversations. And it's not going to be exhaustive on the needs that I've heard from partners out there. You know, we have challenges. Mark Lindauer was on the Public Records Task Force with me, and he represents small districts. Is he sitting behind me? Because if I'm going to quote him, I need to make sure I get it right. You know, there are rural fire departments. There are small rural school districts. Small rural school districts are really challenging because they're off in the summer, and they may only have a staff of five or less people when they are in school. And so how do they respond to a public records request? So it's not an easy chore to figure all this stuff out. But here's what I envision. An official legislative committee dedicated to public records. Their first order of business would be to work with stakeholders to identify the exemptions that should remain on the exemption list. And there are reasons for that. As I've worked with Lindsay Baker from DAS and the Oregon Department of Justice, the judicial branch, there are definitely exemptions that have federal law, federal requirements. There are a variety of reasons why there are exemptions that we don't want to sunset and have to every so many years go back and rehash them. HIPAA laws and, you know, privilege laws and things like that that we understand and we can all agree that they shouldn't be sunset. The remaining exemptions would be categorized, and Michael Kron.
Yeah, if you want him to come up.
You want to come up, Michael? Come on. Michael's done, Michael chaired the AG's Task Force on Public Records and did a phenomenal amount of pre-work for our Senate bill and also for this. And so I would envision that taking a lot of the work that Michael has done, the database that's been created and will continue evolving, would the committee would take this body of work, categorize it, and I know Michael's already done some categorizing, but categorize the exemptions, and every biennium, this committee would rotate through 20% of those if we stick with the 10-year sunsetting rotation. That was just simple math. I was trying to figure out 550 exemptions, how many of them might be kept as permanent exemptions, what would that leave, divide that by, so it was just simple math. So every biennium then they would hold hearings and determine, which is very similar to the tax credit, you know, how many of those would we allow to sunset and which ones deserve to that's kind of the premise and what my vision is for this. It sounds complicated. I honestly don't think it's that complicated. I think it's something we could get done this session to implement and kick off. I understand that there has been testimony that in another committee that, you know, this is probably not the session for it, and we should punt it to another session. The next session will say, that's not the right session, we should punt it to another session. I think there's a strong desire for the transparency and the need to clean up. I mean, we are unique as a state with 550 some odd exemptions. You know, we might find out that, darn it, we need all of them. But I kind of doubt that. Some of the other things that I think this legislative committee could work on are the other things that we heard in committee, and I've heard since then, out talking to local governments and also people that request public records. And oftentimes, it's a question of scope. One sheriff was saying that he struggles with attorneys saying, I need everything surrounding this case. And that's where I think possibly, if need be, last resort could be the ombudsman that we're talking about developing. But so surrounding the ask or the scope. And then on the flip side of that is typically the local government or small government entity, sheriff's office or whatever, you know, they're inundated by these. They don't have the additional personnel to meet that, and so they're going to have to pay overtime and whatever, and particularly sheriff said, so I just told the attorney it's going to be $15,000 for that public records request. Well, it may or may not have been a legitimate answer, response of $15,000. So I think the committee could, if we had a dedicated committee looking at this all the time and the challenges around public records, we could be a much more transparent state and get some of these problems resolved without going to, because I think there's going to be